Right, listen, I'm here with British Boxers website, and we're down here for an amateur show in Ashton at the Masonic Hall. As you can see, I'm here with the champ, and still the champ, the WBO lightweight champion of the world, Terry Turbo Flanagan, and I'm here with the main man of this event. It is, of course, Mr. Thomas McDonough.
The DILF.
The DILF of boxing, and he's called the DILF because all the housewives want a piece, you know what I'm saying? Now, firstly, tell us about this show firstly, Tommy, and then we're going to obviously move on and talk to the champ as well.
It's just an annual club amateur boxing show, dinner show. Try to raise a few quid for the club and obviously get all our young fighters out. And seven of them making their debuts today, so it's a bit of a nerve-wracking experience.
And you seem pretty excited. Is it because it's like a big moment for you here to have these shows on?
Do you know what? I've done most of these tables in here, but obviously yeah. We've got people like Terry coming and it's great for the kids.
Terry, how important is it to have a good like amateur setup?
Yeah, it's good. I mean, I didn't have the best amateur career myself, but it's important. It's where you learn all the basics and stuff like that. So, yeah, people like Tommy and that learning these kids, hopefully one day they can get to the level where I am, which is at the highest level.
He's the champ.
And listen, it's great that you turn up to these events, you know, because the little kids, like I was here with some little kids earlier, as soon as they seen you, Terry Turbo, they ran off. You know, do you feel like it's important that fighters like yourself, champs like yourself, come down and support the local shows?
Yeah, I mean, it's great for the kids to look up to me, because I used to do the exact same thing with the likes of Ricky Atom, and I used to see him at amateur boxing shows, so it's good that they look up to me. But like I say, I don't see myself as anyone special, so yeah, but it's great that people that I look up to me.
I mean, I know you say that, but obviously you are the undefeated lightweight champ of the world. How does it feel to actually, I know you say it don't mean anything, you're very humble with it, but are you aware of how important it is that you're a world champion from Manchester down at a local show?
Probably not, no, not really, but I understand what you're saying. It's a big achievement and stuff, but I don't really think about it. Probably when I look back in a few years when I've retired, I probably think, wow, I was champion of the world, but for now I'm always striving for more bigger and better things. So hopefully like, you can get them big fights next year and win them and win more titles, unify the division and
fantastic
stuff like that.
And what we'll do is we'll come back in a second to you and talk about some of them potential matchups. Tommy, let me just ask you quickly, who are we looking out for tonight? Any prospects on the bill tonight?
Do you know what? I'm not going to put loads of pressure on them. Like I say, there's seven of them making their debuts tonight. So some 50-50 matches, if anything, we're up against it. So we're giving a bit of weight away, a bit of experience. So, no, it's all about learning and who knows.
And I know you work really well with Pat Barrett. Of course, he does the pros. You sort the amateurs and they get when they turn over, they go and work with Pat. You're completely different characters. How does that work, you and Pat Barrett together? I know you've got a great team. How does it work?
It's a bit like sweet. Was it sweet and was it sweet and sour? Is it?
Yeah. No, it's like sweet chocolate, baby.
I'm sweet and he's a bit sour, so yeah. We can't be too serious like Pat. We can't be too giddy like me. So we help each other out. And he's late as usual. Told him to get here for 7. And it's 8 o'clock.
And when is the first bout tonight?
Should have been 10 minutes ago. waiting for Pat. When Pat comes, we're going to start. Yeah.
All right, nice one. And listen, Terry, I'm just going back to you a second here, Terry. You've talked about, I mean, your last opponent, Orlando Cruz. You pretty much, I mean, no disrespect to him, but you pretty much, you handled your business there. You destroyed
him
pretty much. Beat him up, yeah. I know you get asked this a lot with, I don't even know what's going on. Is that a selfie or is it just Pat Barrett? Obviously, there's some big fights out there for you. There's the likes of the unification fights. There's domestic fights that are big as well. If you had your ideal pick of the fights, what would it be?
Probably Linares. He's the one with the WBA or Zlatan Cannon. The winner is Zlatan Cannon and Mikey Garcia. That's another big fight.
That's
Robert Easter. All the likes of Lomachenko, who's possibly moving up to lightweight. It's another big fight he's seen. It's probably pound for pound the best. So if Frank can make them fights happen, he's confident that he's going to get me them big fights next year. And if it does, I'll be made up, because that's what I've been calling for a while now.
Exactly, and you've been calling for these big fights. Now, the Lomachenko fight, and as you said, Lomachenko really up there on the pound-for-pound list. It's refreshing to see that you actually want to take on all comers. You're not bothered. You're not trying to avoid people and, you know, oh, Lomachenko, he's pound-for-pound, I want to avoid him. You want to go straight for the best fights out there.
Yeah, I mean, great fighter like Lomachenko have been the best out of me. You see the best Terry Flanagan. I'm a natural lightweight and big. He's a super featherweight coming up, so that puts me at an advantage. And Yeah, I know I'm big, strong at the weight, and I reckon I could beat anyone at lightweight in the world.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. And just before we sort of round this off, in terms of, you just mentioned there, you're comfortable at the weight, you're the best at the weight. There has been this talk of potentially going up to 140 pounds. Is that something that's going to happen, you think, sooner or later, if you can't get a big fight at 135, in the very near future?
Well, Frank's promised me these big fights next year now. I said I've got a couple more fights in me at lightweight, because it's starting to take away from my performance now, getting down to the weight. But yeah, if the right fight come available at 140, I jump at the chance. If the right fight, right money, I take it. I mean, Crawford's got the WBO at the weight above, and there was rumours that he was going to vacate, and if he did vacate and the fight was got the right fight and the right sort of money, I'd jump up and fight it, yeah.
Fantastic. And just whilst I've got you both here, obviously you're both guys with a vast amount of experience. What tips could you give amateur fighters just setting out on their career? I'll go to you first, Tommy. What tips can you give any amateur fighters out there who want to know something from people like yourself?
Do you know what? It's like, just train hard, give it a go. Terry's from Ancoats, young boy. Do you know what I mean? I remember when he came into the gym, just like a young kid turning pro. Now he's champion of the world, and he's not got that through watching Jeremy Kyle. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. He's got that through training hard, dedicating, sacrificing. And if you want to make something of yourself, you've got to do what this guy's done, and he's cut himself off from everything. Trained hard, and no, just I'm not like this. Doesn't mean if he can do it, just a normal kid, then they can do it, innit, Terry? He's from the streets, he's from like us all, he's done it, he's a world champion. So if that's telling you, listen, he's come from Ancoats, it's not the booking, sorry for swearing, it's not the best area, and he's proved and he's come through it, so it's there for you, it's there, you can do it, anyone can do it.
And that's inspirational.
Hard work though, it's got to be hard work, yeah. Nothing else will do. I try to do it the easy way. I never won a world title.
Don't sell yourself short, you had 60 amateur fights out
of contest. I used to cut through the cuff. I meet the lads at the top and have a little rest and wait for them. Yeah. That's where it got me. Whereas he's running round twice.
And same question to you, Terry. Any advice from a world champion to young fighters, aspiring fighters out there, looking at you and thinking, man, I'd love to be there one day.
I just say keep your head down, keep work hard, and if you work hard enough and you want it enough, you'll get it. I mean, I didn't have the best amateur record, but I kept my head down, working hard, and didn't tell no one, listen to no one who said I won't be a world champion, and I am a world champion now. So all you got to do is believe in yourself, and yeah, keep working hard, keep your head down, and don't let no one tell you can't do something, because if you truly believe that you're going to be a champion, you will be.
Absolutely fantastic. And guys, it's been an absolute honour and pleasure to chat with you. Hopefully we'll get a few more words from you later on as well. I'm here with Terry Turbo Flanagan, the WBO lightweight champ, and Mr. Thomas McDonough, who has got this great show going on tonight in Ashton. Power!